The Sherlock Holmes Advent Calendar. The Redeemer's Coming. By Sir Arthur Conan Doyle and Nora Godwin. Narrated by Peter Silverleaf. 11. Inside the Blizzard. The next morning we got up with confidence. We had a new clue to follow. But one thing was clear. If we wanted to find out more about the first murder victim, Brother Emmanuel, or Simon Taylor, as the young man was called prior to joining the convent, we would have to go to his hometown, Teddington. The direct train service between Twickenham and Teddington was, of course, out of service due to the harsh snow, and the roads were also impassable for carriages. Therefore, we had no other choice but to send someone on foot on the 2 miles walk through the snowstorm. And when Holmes was referring to someone, he was usually talking about no one other than me. "Forget it, Holmes," I protested firmly. "I just escaped suffocation and frostbite death under an avalanche at the last second, and now you want to send me out into the snowstorm again? You cannot be serious." "Oh, come on, Watson, don't be like that," Holmes replied. "Where has your spirit of adventure gone? You fought at the Hindu Kush. After all, you are an officer of the Royal British Army." "Retired," I quickly added. "Listen," Holmes continued, undeterred. "We absolutely need this information from Teddington. As you can see, with my leg injury, I am hardly able to take the arduous path through the deep snow, and given that there is still a murderer within this monastery, it seems obvious to me to keep the only policeman at our disposal here as well." "But you can safely do without me," I replied. "Thank you, noble friend. You make me feel absolutely invaluable at times." "Come on, Watson," Holmes insisted in a good-natured voice. "You know as well as I do that you are the only man for this important task." Holmes, weaving buttered compliments like a spider trapping his victim in his complicated web. "Should I really send Inspector Lestrade to get crucial investigative results on his own? The success of this case lies in your hands. You can do it. I am convinced of that." With this, Holmes had artfully coaxed me. I was trapped in a cocoon of my own pride at being praised so highly, while Lestrade had not even noticed that his investigative skills had just been degraded. This was, of course, the last push I needed to commit. "All right," I said with a sigh, "I'll do it. But honestly, I already regret it." Inspector Lestrade used a map to instruct me on the way to Teddington and the surrounding area. We decided against going along the railway route, as it implied a considerable detour. Instead, I planned on walking south and heading over the hill at Strawberry Hill into the Thames Valley, with the goal being Teddington, where the river formed a meander. I was also equipped with a compass and an insulated jug full of tea. I put on my warmest clothes, and on top of them I wore one of the cowls that the Franciscans great-heartedly provided me with. In addition to that, they gave me a companion. Harry was his name, and he was supposed to be the best mule of the abbey. He wouldn't let me ride him, but would pull me through the deep snow, especially in the passages that led uphill. Holmes and Lestrade said goodbye to me at the large, heavy gates of the abbey as I crammed my sparse luggage. "I'm going to light a candle for you in the chapel," said Holmes, who apparently thought that this was a good way to encourage me. "Not necessary," I replied, hiding my irritated undertone. "I'm not dead yet, Holmes." "As you wish," Holmes replied, "or should I ask Brother Francis to pray for you?" "I'm not a Catholic," I replied, annoyed, secretly considering a sincere intercession. "The least it would do is cause any further damage, right?" "Good luck," wished Lestrade in his own simple directness. "Goodbye," I said, and began with my awkward mission. Holmes and Lestrade watched my first arduous steps out of the abbey, but then I heard the door of the abbey closing, and I knew that from that point on, I was on my own.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.